Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I'm going to show you how to install the latest version of Spyder IDE on the Windows operating system. And after that, I'm also going to show you how to use Spyder IDE for Python programmings. Should you watch the video till the end, I can guarantee if you watch the video till the end, you'll be learning a lot of new things. And if you're still facing any issues in middle, you can always ask me on comment sections. And I'm also on Instagram now, so you can also follow me over there and you can ask all of your doubts over there as well. I'm definitely going to help you. So now to install Spyder IDE, you need to first simply go to favorite browser and to search over here, Spyder IDE download. Hit enter. So that will show you the spyderide.org. So just you need to go to their official site and you'll be landed over to the official site of Spyder. So this link I'm going to provide right in your description. Once when you are here, you'll see that it is already detected that I'm using a Windows operating system. So we have a download button over here. If you want also going to download it for Linux or macOS, for M1 chip or Intel, you can always proceed with all these different links. But I'm going to download it for Windows on this particular video. So I'm going to click on this button and immediately we'll see that our Spyder IDE is actually started downloading, right? So I have already downloaded it, so I'll cancel this. I'll minimize my browser. I'll go to my download directory. And you can see that our Spyder IDE is already downloaded over here. And the file size is 547 MB. Alright, so now to install it, just simply double click on this installer. So that's going to open your Spyder IDE installation wizard. So you can minimize your download directory. So welcome to Spyder version 6.2.3. Just simply click on next over here. So these are all license agreement. You must read this. Click on I agree. So here it is asking whether you'd like to install it for just me or for all users. I recommend you, since if you are only going to use this PC, so you can keep it just me, which is also a documented one also. So you can just keep it default and click on next. So this is where our Spyder IDE is going to be installed. So on our users folder within app data, it's going to create a local, has a local folder. So within that, it's going to create a Spyder 6 folder. All right. So everything is fine. Just keep it default. Only thing that you need to check is this available space and required space. So you need to have that much amount of space and you need to keep it default and click on next. So again, here also keep everything as default and click on install. So immediately we'll see our installation is rightly begun. And also click on the show details to see how it is doing. All right. So yeah, so it's going to take some time, couple of minutes maybe. So by the time it gets installed, I'll request you to subscribe your channel Geeky Script along with Geeky Syntax as well. So here also regularly I'm posting lot of coding related videos, so don't forget to subscribe our channel Geeky Syntax. And I am also posting lot of videos on WordPress, so if you want, you can always watch this entire playlist. So some videos are 1 hour, some videos are 1 hour 30 minute video, some are little shorter. So you can watch all these videos, you know, for completely free on our channel. So that's going to really help you to learn more about building a entire website from scratch, and these are all commercial website. You can use it for commercial purpose as well. All right, so you can, you know, watch all these different videos. And here let's wait for some time. So we'll come back, and now you can clearly see that our Spyder IDE is ready installed. So installation is completed, message is also showing. Just simply click on next and click on finish. So now that you know that our Spyder IDE is rightly installed, so we have a desktop shortcut also created over here. So just simply double click on the shortcut to launch our latest version of Spyder IDE, that is version 6. And our Spyder IDE is rightly started launching. And it has rightly launched. So this is the interface of our Spyder IDE. Here we have a console and here is our program writing area. So you can write your all Python code snippets over here. You can create a new file. So you need to click on this icon and there you go. We have a new file. You can also go to file and click on new file. So that's going to also create a new file. So let's save this one of our files. So just, you know, go to file and click on save as. And let's save one file on our desktop. Just go to desktop and just write the file name as probably proc.py and click on save. So our file is rightly saved, and here you can write your Python code snippets. So let's write something. Let's add couple of two number. So let's say a equal to 5 and b equal to, let's say, 6, and let's do summation of these two number. So print a plus b. All right, and we also want to print something, let's say a simple string like welcome to Spyder IDE. All right, so I just write something like this and save this file. You can click on this icon to save this file, and then you can click on this icon, so that going to immediately show you the output over your console. So 5 plus 6 11 is properly showing, along with also that welcome note. So welcome to Spyder IDE, so that is also showing over here. You can also see this variable explorer. So all these different values that we have initialized, like a value we have initialized with 5, v variable we have initialized with 6. So all these different variables, like name of our variable a is initialized by 5, b initialized by 6 with a unit size of 1, and it is an integer type. So all this it is properly showing over here, right? So let's say you are making 6.5, and you want to print 5 plus 6.5. so just save this file and click on this run button, and this time you can see it is showing the output here, and also it is showing what type of variable it is. So 6.5 is a float, so that is also it is clearly showing over here, right? So 6.5 and 5. So all these things does on this variable explorer. So let's say you are assigning one more value, creating one more variable c, and this time you are initializing with a string. So save this file, click on run button, and this time you can see for variable 6 it is a string integer, and that is also showing, right? So what happens is, like, when you write big Python programs and you want to debug it, it really helpful. So it shows all these different values on this variable explorer. You can also debug it. So you need to click on this icon, and you can see here we have a debugger, and it is rightly started running. So you need to click on this icon, and you can see that our line 1 is rightly started executing. So just keep on clicking, and from here our programming is actually starting. So a equal to 5, so when you click on that, immediately you see one variable a getting registered over here, right? So you click on this icon again, so our b value get registered. It is also showing over our output window as well, and here we are initializing. In the previous line we have initialized hello, so that is also showing. Again, when you click on that, it's going to show the output, so that is also showing. So print a plus b 11.5. again, you click on that and you get this welcome note. So click on that again, and that line is when get executed, you get that output, right? So in this way, you can also debug your Python program on Spyder IDE. So it is a very useful idea, I must say. So do use your Spyder IDE for Python programmings. You can start your machine learning journey also on Spyder IDE. Alright, so that's basically all about this video, friends. Don't forget to watch our WordPress playlist as well on our channel. And lastly, special thanks to the supporters of our channel. We are truly grateful to you guys. Supports like this really motivate us to create and improving these videos. Again, thanks a lot for being an essential part of our journey. So that's basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.